From Bundjalung Country, this is Sunday Mass with Bishop Greg Homeming.
Of the Father, of the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we continue to go through ordinary time, let's in an ordinary way just place ourselves in the presence of God, seeking the mercy and love of our loving Father. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ of mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth peace to people of good will.
We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God,
heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world,
receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Holy One,
you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Show favour, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord appeared to Abraham at the oak of Mamre, while he was sitting by the entrance of the tent during the hottest part of the day. He looked up, and there he saw three men standing near him. As soon as he saw them, he ran from the entrance of the tent to meet them and bowed to the ground. My Lord, he said, I beg you, if I find favour with you, kindly do not pass your servant by. A little water shall be brought. You shall wash your feet and lie down under the tree. Let me fetch a little bread, and you shall refresh yourselves before going further. That is why you have come in your servant's direction. They replied, Do as you say. Abraham hastened to the tent to find Sarah. Hurry, he said. Knead three bushels of flour and make loaves. Then running to the cattle, Abraham took a fine and tender calf and gave it to the servant, who hurried to prepare it. Then taking cream, milk, and the calf he had prepared, he laid all before them, and they ate while he remained standing near them under the tree. Where is your wife Sarah? They asked him. She is in the tent, he replied. Then his guest said, I shall visit you again next year without fail, and your wife will then have a son. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The just will live in the presence of the Lord.
He
The just will live in the presence of the Lord.
Lord, who shall dwell on your holy mountain? He who walks without fault, he who acts with justice and speaks the truth from his heart, he who does not slander with his tongue.
The just will live in the presence of the Lord.
He who does no wrong to his brother, who casts no slur on his neighbour, who holds the godless in disdain, but honours those who fear the Lord.
The just will live in the presence of the Lord.
He who keeps his pledge, come what may, who take no interest on a loan and accepts no bribes against the innocent, such a man will stand firm forever.
The just will live in the presence of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. It makes me happy to suffer for you, as I am suffering now, and in my body to do what I can to make up all that has still to be undergone by Christ for the sake of his body, the Church. I became the servant of the Church when God made me responsible for delivering God's message to you. The message which was a mystery hidden for generations and centuries and has now been revealed to his saints. It was God's purpose to reveal it to them and to show all the rich glory of this mystery to pagans. The mystery of Christ is among you, your hope of glory. This is the Christ we proclaim. This is the wisdom in which we thoroughly train everyone and instruct everyone to make them all perfect in Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Happy are they who have kept the word with a generous heart and yield a harvest through perseverance. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus came to a village, and a woman named Martha welcomed him into her house. She had a sister called Mary, who sat down at the Lord's feet and listened to him speaking. Now Martha, who was distracted with all the serving, said, Lord, do you not care that my sister is leaving me to do all the serving all by myself? Please tell her to help me. But the Lord answered, Martha, Martha, he said, you worry and fret about many things, and yet few are needed. Indeed, only one. It is Mary who has chosen the better part. It is not to be taken from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Perhaps the most difficult part of joining the Carmelites wasn't so much what you would think it was, not having things, not being able to do things. The most difficult part of the early life of a Carmelite was that I had to spend so much time in my room, except when I had reason to be out of my room. I was meant to be in my room either praying, reading, being with God. And it sounds like a wonderful possibility, but 7 days a week, it started to become very difficult. And I suppose there would have been times as a novice that I was almost climbing the walls of my room. So I would leave my door open sometimes. My novice master would walk by and insist that my door be closed, so I'd close it. And I look back on those times and with some kind of affection, it was a struggle to be alone, to be in my own alone, and to be free of all the things that used to be important to me, of things, of different foods, of people, of what I called freedom. I had to give all of that up for the freedom of myself, for the freedom of my room. Now, as the years have gone on as a Carmelite, I long for that freedom of my own space to such an extent that I don't like being with people for too long or with too many people, because that inner space which 30-something years as a Carmelite has helped me develop is so part of me that I kind of long for it when it's absent. In today's gospel, we've got a very interesting moment. We've got Martha wanting to do all these things for Jesus, and Mary just wanting to sit at his feet and listen to him. Listen to him, that's a very important part of it, because listening is so difficult. How often have you talked to somebody and at the end of the discussion recognize that they haven't really listened to you? And if we're honest, how often have people spoken to us and we've not really listened to them properly? Because listening is a very difficult thing. It's difficult because we don't have that inner freedom, that inner space, that space that my time as a Carmelite has tried to teach me. Because the great truth is, we listen to ourselves. We listen to our thoughts, we listen to our conclusions, we think we know what the person is talking about. We know everything because we are in fact listening to ourselves. And so often that's the same thing that happens to us. You talk to someone with a problem and they're already solving your problem before they've listened to you, because they know. It's already within them. This was Martha's problem. Jesus comes to the house of Martha and Mary, and Mary's only concern is, what can I do for him? Without even the question, I wonder what he wants me to do for him. Without even the question, I wonder whether he can bring something to me. But rather, she is consumed with her inner conflict and concerns and busyness. Whereas Mary doesn't have this. She's able to simply sit there and listen. That thing I spoke about, which is so difficult. So is today's gospel about listening? Yes and no. I think it's more importantly about what's necessary in order that I might be able to listen. What is it that Mary has that Martha doesn't have? And what Mary has that Martha doesn't have is an inner solitude. That inner solitude is something which is so rare in the world today. People do not like to be alone. People do not like to have nothing to do. People do not like to be undistracted. The modern person tries to fill themselves with things because they're afraid of the alone. They're afraid of the inner solitude. But that inner solitude is life. That inner solitude is my freedom, because that inner solitude is the real me. I am not the things that I fill myself up with. I'm not the distractions that consume me. I am an inner solitude that waits to be filled with the love of God, that waits to listen to the voice of Jesus Christ, that recognizes Jesus as someone who wants to come to me and loves me. Martha did not recognize this. She only found within herself the need to do something for him, which was her personal need to do something for anybody. Whereas Mary had that solitude. What can I do to develop this solitude? I think there are a number of things. To begin by emptying myself of those things which make it impossible for me to have the freedom that I need. Not simply to empty myself, but not to crave, not to desire, not to reach out for things to fill me. We live in a world where the world would say, live by your desires. No, That's not freedom. If I live by my desires, I will never have that solitude. Because the only desire that I have, which is important, is the desire that Mary had, which was simply to sit at the feet of Jesus and to listen. To what? She didn't know. I don't know. But it's that inner solitude. I pray that you will all develop this solitude. And once it starts to develop within you, that you will hold on to it and let it grow. Because anything contrary to this solitude will ensure that you will perhaps never know the richness and the fullness of God. Let's stand and profess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. With the inner freedom of Mary, let us bring our prayers to our Heavenly Father.
That the sacred liturgy may enrich the personal prayer of those assembled for worship. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of our nation will give glory to God by using their talents to serve us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Sisters of St. Joseph in New South Wales, as they celebrate 150 years since arriving from Adelaide to begin ministry in this state. May the inspiration of Mary MacKillop and Julian Tennyson Woods continue to bring hope to a needy world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Australian communities devastated by present floods and past bushfires, that they will have all the resources and resilience they need to recover. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who are sick and bereaved may receive healing and acceptance through Christ and the intercession of St. Mary of the Cross. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may live forever in the presence of the Lord, especially Pat Khan, Michael Condon, Narissa Hu, Barry Woppet, Greg Sullivan, and Inez Jones. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we make these and all our prayers through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
Accept the sacrifice under your hand.
praise the glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
And let us pray. O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honour of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set us over the whole world in its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection
until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, Saint Teresa, Saint John of the Cross, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours for ever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Forgive us our trespasses, as we
forgive those who trespass against us.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God.
Take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word and my soul shall be. And let us pray.
Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Trees do.